Hey everyone, welcome to Tea Time. COVID Quarantea Time with Santosh. Day 212, it feels like. Anyway, it is Monday. No, it's not. It's Tuesday, April 14th. I'm coming to you live from my incarceration location of my house in Ithaca, New York. And I'm trying to up the production value a little bit of this thing, so we'll see how it goes. So today I want to talk to you in the area of spiritual formation and spiritual development. So one thing this lockdown has caused is people are finding that they are having extra time on their hands due to not being in the office. So even if you're working from home, you may not be as productive as if you were going into the office. So it's an ideal time, if you haven't already, to develop the habit of prayer and Bible reading. If you grew up in the church, you know that having a daily quiet time is very, very important. And though many of us have heard that many, many, many times, very few of us actually do that. And I'm talking here about regular, once a week, church attenders. The percentages are extremely low of people who actually read their Bible and pray. So I want to encourage you to do that, and I want to give you some tips on how to do it. First, pick a time. So pick a time that works for your schedule. Could be morning, could be lunchtime, it could be afternoon, it could be evening. It really depends on you and your schedule. I would make a case for doing it in the morning, because that kind of sets your, well, thanks, Sophia. Would you like to say hi?
Hi.
There's my beautiful daughter. It's her birthday in 2 days. Yeah, she's running away. So first of all, pick a time. I would argue for morning before you do anything else, or after you shower, have breakfast or whatever, have a cup of coffee and sit down with your Bible. Secondly, pick a place. Maybe it's a favorite chair, maybe it's a home office, maybe it's a room, maybe it's outside on your deck, but pick a place that you're going to use to be your regular quiet time area. And thirdly, pick a plan. If you just pick up your Bible and sort of randomly open it up to whatever and just do that over and over again, it's not going to be very compelling. Even just picking up the Bible and reading it straight through can be challenging, because you'll hit Leviticus and Numbers and some books that aren't that, can't hold your attention that much. So pick a plan. The good news for all of us today is, because of the Bible app YouVersion, there's tons of plans that are very, very easy to access right on our phones. So if you don't have YouVersion Bible app, I would recommend you get that for your phone and pick a plan. So the plan that I use is a plan that I have been using for almost 20 years. It started in 2001 in my first year at seminary. Our professor handed out this sheet. It looked like this. It wasn't exactly this, but it looked a lot like this. And this is called the McShane Calendar for Daily Bible Readings. So this plan was created in the 19th century by a guy named Robert Murray McShane, who is a Scottish pastor and writer. And so with this plan, you go through the Old Testament once and the New Testament and Psalms twice in 1 year. So I've done that for almost 20 years. I've gone regularly through the Bible. And reading through the Bible in a year is actually not as intimidating as it sounds. I know it sounds kind of like trying to run a marathon or something. But with this plan, so let's look at what I read for today. So it's April 14th today. So where's April? So April 14th, I read Leviticus 18, Psalm 22, Ecclesiastes 1, and 2 Timothy 3. So that takes actually under 10 minutes just to read those four. So just 10 minutes a day with this plan. You can have plans that are even shorter than that. Or another way of doing it is just reading a psalm every day. That's very, very good, very helpful. Just read one psalm a day. So that's the Bible reading part. Pick a time, pick a place, pick a plan, and just start doing it. You can start today. Now, the second part is prayer. Now, unlike Bible reading, I find prayer really, really hard. It's very, very challenging. And it does not come naturally to me. I could read long portions of scripture, and I have. I've read through the book of Romans. I've read through Gospels all in one sitting. That's not a problem for me. But praying has always been hard. I don't know why. So to sort of help me in that area of prayer, I do two things. I always have by my side, by my Bible, I have a book on prayer. So I have probably 10 different books on prayer that I've read over the years. And if a book looks good that's on prayer, I'll buy it and start reading it. So this is the one I'm reading right now, Prayer and Practice by Simon Tugwell. He's actually Roman Catholic, so you kind of have to, if you're a Protestant like me, you have to skip over some of the Catholic parts. I wouldn't say this is a great book. It's been okay. I'm about almost finished it. And so I'll take a book like this, or I'll take, what's another famous book on prayer? Philip Yancey has a book on prayer that's helpful. Eugene Peterson has a book on praying through the Psalms, which is helpful. So I'll take a book like that, and I'll actually just read maybe 2 or 3 pages. I won't read a lot, but just enough to sort of get me inspired or give me some ideas on how to pray or what to pray. The second thing I do is I have probably 2 or 3 different books of collected prayer. So this one is called A Diary of Private Prayer by John Bailey. And I just find it helpful to have prayers that have been written by others that are a little bit more eloquent. And I read through them and I pray through them. And after a while, then I can just pray my own prayers to God. So those are my little tips that I do that kind of keep me on that path of keeping that habit going. So I really want to challenge you to use this time where we can be still and know that He is God, to really use it. And so that at the end of your quarantine time, when we come out of it, you can look back and see how you've actually grown spiritually through this habit of daily Bible reading and prayer. So having said that, I'm going to close with a prayer from this book by John Bale. So let's go with the 14th day. So let's pray together. O you who indwellest in our poor and shabby human life, lifting it now and then above the dominance of animal passion and greed, allowing it to shine with the borrowed lights of love and joy and peace, and making it a mirror of the beauties of a world unseen. Grant that my part in the world's life today may not be to obscure the splendor of your presence, but rather to make it more plainly visible to the eyes of my fellow men. Let me stand today for whatever is pure and true and just and good, for the advancement of science and education and true learning, for the redemption of daily business from the blight of self-seeking, for the rights of the weak and the oppressed, for industrial cooperation and mutual help, for the conservation of the rich traditions of the past, for the recognition of new workings of your spirit in the minds of the men of my own time, for the hope of yet more glorious days to come. Today, O Lord, let me put right before interest. Let me put others before self. Let me put the things of the spirit before the things of the body. Let me put the attainment of noble ends above the enjoyment of present pleasures. Let me put principles above reputation. Let me put you before all else. O you, the reflection of whose transcendent glory did once appear unbroken in the face of Jesus Christ, give me today a heart like his, a brave heart, a true heart, a tender heart, a heart with great room in it, a heart fixed on yourself for your name's sake. Amen. Amen. So I look forward to hearing from many of you of how it's going in picking up this habit of daily Bible reading and prayer. All right, until next time, keep washing your hands.